Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitter, a retired lecturer in Mataraji preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to render exposition of Luke 13:18-30. Then said he unto, what is the royal kingdom of God like, and where unto shall I resemble it? It is like a grain of mustard seed. Grain of mustard seed means a person who is very humble, or he thinks he is the lowest of the low, which a man took and cast into his garden. Man is God, and the garden is the vineyard of God, the word. And it grew and waxed a great tree and became a great tree and became a saint. So people, you know, who are, you remember that some became the bastard born of the prostitutes. They are called eunuch in moral laws because they cannot reproduce children because they have no seed. So they are the lowest seed. So they are the, Christ Jesus in Matthew 19 said, some eunuchs were born from the womb of the woman, so they are the bastard born of the prostitutes, and some became eunuchs for the kingdom of God. So some people have left their family homes, and they left their tribal identity also to go for wilderness and meditate on His word, like John the Baptist. He left his family home and went to wilderness. So he became eunuch for the kingdom of heaven. So the mustard seed are people normally who are devote their life to God, and they meditate upon His word, and they become big knowledgeable people, big trees. And the birds of the air stands for people who are sensible. Remember that the birds have strong sensory organs, so they are very sensible. It is leaven, it is lodged in the branches, and waxed a great tree, and the fowls of the air lodge. Fowls of the air mean sensible people who have common sense, lodged in the branches of it. Branches of it mean they came and sat around him. And again he said, whereunto shall I liken the royal kingdom of God? It is like leaven which a woman took and hid in 3 measures of meal till the whole was leavened. So a woman in here is the Holy Spirit, which she took the leaven. Leaven is the agape, the divine love of the people who are believing in God. You have arrow. Arrow is the love between flesh, between your relations, between your husband and wife, and all that which is limited. And when you know our Father God, then you have divine love with each other. You have divine brethren, not tribal brethren anymore. Gentile and Jews, they are the same. Color, brown, white, or anything, they are the same. So we are brethren in God. And those who are brethren in God, they exercise divine love called agape. So this leaven is the agape. So the 3 layers are the people of the 3 types. Once born, twice born doubting, twice born sealed to serve God. So that's the 3 layers. So this leaven is put into 3 layers of flour. That means the church people, they should love each other like for children of the same Father God. and their love should be agape, not arrows. Till the whole was leavened, the whole church was, you know, became full of agape. And he went, that means after leaven, it makes a big loaf. Big loaf is the congregation of the church. And he went through the cities and villages preaching and journeying towards Jerusalem. So he started going towards the Jerusalem. Then said one unto him, Lord, are there few that be saved? So these people, Lord, they will say, you know, our master, they will say, to give him a boost, you know, in ego and to in respect from their point. And he said unto them, strive to enter in at the straight gate. Straight means narrow gate. For many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in and shall not be able. So shall not be able to enter. That means many want to seek to enter into this straight gate, a narrow gate, but you have to find it. If you are blind, then you cannot find it. So many are seeking to enter into that gate. For to enter that gate, you must open your third eye of logical reasoning. So if your third eye for logical reasoning is open, then you will find the straight gate, and then you can enter into it. When once the master of the house is risen up and hath shut to the door, and ye begin to stand without and to knock at the door, saying, Lord, Lord, open unto us, he shall answer and say unto you, I know you not, whence ye are. Remember the parable of 10 virgins? So here he is telling the same thing, that when you are sealed to serve God, or when you are sensible, then you should be sincere. You should work hard to build up the faith. Faith is the oil. So if your faith is not developed, then you cannot last till the door is opened. So those whose faith was less, they went later on and they could not enter in time, so they were shut out. This has been given in the parable for the 10 virgins. The 5 are doubting type and 5 are sealed to serve God. Those 5 which were sealed to serve God, they had enough oil or faith, so they enter into the kingdom of God. While those who had less, they went away to buy some more or to build some more, and they were too late to in their life to enter into the straight gate or into the royal kingdom of God. Then shall ye begin to say, we have eaten and drunk in thy presence, and thou hast taught in our streets. So they will say, you know, that we were there when you were preaching and all that, but what's the use of listening to the gospel truth if you can't put it into practice? So eating and drinking, you are in the houses. This is the age when you are, while you are drinking and eating, you attain your salvation or find the narrow straight gate and enter into the royal kingdom of God. But he shall say, I tell you, I know you not, whence ye are, depart from me, all ye workers of iniquity. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth, and when ye shall see Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and all the prophets in the royal kingdom of God, and you yourself thrust out. And they shall come from the east, from the west, and from the north, and from the south, and shall sit down in the royal kingdom of God. And behold, there are last which shall be first, and there are first which shall be last. Remember that when Christ Jesus paid the wages to the laborers at Pentecost, the last was paid first, and the first was paid last. And God bless you. Thank you.